Hello everyone, we are a few minutes late for this live demo today. And today, the topic of the demo is how to run iPerf on the NetBiz dashboard. I won't go into what NetBiz is and what we do, but in a nutshell, I would say that we use network sensors to capture user experience performance from different locations of your network. And one way to do that is by using iPerf. And iPerf, for the ones that don't know, is a tool that you can use it on a Linux command line or a Windows machine, right? Or MacBook. And what it does, it's a tool that pushes traffic from a source to a destination. And you can see pretty much how much traffic you can push between two hosts. So if you want to test your connection, your WAN network, whatever that is, right? And you can see, hey, can I push 50, 100, 500 megabps? You can do that with iPerf. In our case, we use iPerf to send traffic from one sensor on our dashboard to another. And there are two ways to do that. So I'm showing you here our dashboard, and I'm showing you here for the purpose of this demo, it's a number of agents we have in our office, in our lab in Pittsburgh. You can see here, that is the basic 10100 agent. We have also a gigabit agent here, second 10100 agent, and a wireless agent. So what I'm going to do initially is I'm going to run an iPerf test between two wired agents in what we call with an ad hoc test. So I'm going to go here to the ad hoc test. And this one now is, it gives you the ability to run, you know, a type of test on the NetBiz dashboard, like ping DNS HTTP and iPerf also, as a one-off test, right? So let's say I really quickly want to test, hey, how much bandwidth can I push between my two 10100 Pittsburgh agents. I'm gonna choose them from here, Pittsburgh 2 and Pittsburgh. And now there are two types of iPerf test. One is the TCP iPerf, which pushes as much traffic between the two ends as possible. And when I say as much traffic as possible, that depends on a couple of factors, right? One is how much traffic the actual host can push in terms of how much CPU, you know, how much traffic the CPU can push, right? The other one is, of course, what the connection between the two hosts looks like. If I have a gigabit connection, if I have a 10 gigabit connection, and so on and so forth, right? So in this case, these two hosts, Pittsburgh 2 and Pittsburgh, these two NetBiz agents, are on a 10100, have 10100 interfaces, right? And if I run the iPerf test, we'll see that the result for the TCP test in this case is gonna be less than 100 Mbps. So just a note here, when you run it's like this, an iPerf test on the NetBiz dashboard. What we do is that first we pause all tests on the agents, because when you run a test of this kind of, like an iPerf, right? What happens is that the, let me try with another agent, it didn't work, this one. What happens is that the CPU, of course, needs to push all this traffic between the two agents. And if we have other processes, other tests on the agents running, then what's gonna happen is that all of the tests are gonna get skewed, and we don't want that, right? So we pause other tests on the agents, and then we run the iPerf test. After the iPerf test is done, we resume all other tests like ping DNS HTTP and traceroute. Okay, let's give it here a second to get the results in. Let me take up to like a minute, I would say, for this test. So while we're waiting for this test, let me show you the second way you can run iPerf tests on NetBiz agents. So that's with the schedule test. So we'll come back to this one once it's done. Let me go here to the test view. And under the tests, you have what we call the scheduled iPerf tests, okay? So with this one now, what happens is that with the ad hoc testing, right, you can run the test as in one off, right? So you run the test, you see the results there, and that's all you get. But let's say that you want to put the iPerf test to run on a schedule, on a periodic basis, so that, first of all, you don't have to run it manually again and again. And then you need to keep historical and have some information there that you can analyze over the course of the time. And as an example here, we're running this iPerf test, the last one. I'll take an example of the last one here, between a virtual agent to our gigabit agent we have in our lab. So, and this is, the test runs every day on the 5th and 45th minute of the hour, every hour. So as you can see, it runs continuously, and the values we get here are close to 100 megabits. Actually, they are 94.4 consistently. And the reason for that is that these two endpoints, these two ports, are connected over a 10-100 switch. So of course, the limit there of the performance we get is almost 100 megabits, right? But again, the idea here, you have very solid results. Of course, everything is very flat here because you get this performance consistently. So this is the schedule type of iPerf, where you run it again on a schedule. And keep in mind here that iPerf is a test that pushes actual traffic in your network. So you don't want to run it too often, right? Because you're going to affect actually your actual network, right? So once an hour might be acceptable. It's a lab environment, so we run it twice an hour actually. Or you can, with the schedule we have on the dashboard, you can choose to run it maybe twice during business hours, and then maybe a couple more times during off hours at 11 p.m. and 2 a.m. Right? Let's go back to the ad hoc testing here that we ran earlier, and we can see that this iPerf test that we ran earlier worked, of course, it took a minute, and the results came in. And this is very similar to what we see on when we run the test on the command line, for the ones who are familiar with that. Of course, you can do a UDP iPerf. That's the test where you can define how much traffic you want to choose. If you want to push 5, 10 megabps, 250 megabps, whatever makes sense for you. Run a multicast iPerf between two agents, and also like set a TOS flag and other options iPerf tests. And so with that, I'm done with this part of the demo today. If you have any questions or comments, please put them on underneath the Facebook live stream right now, and we'll follow up with you to answer your questions or comments. Thanks a lot. Bye.